see if we can do the base of this thing. I'm gonna put these aside of the nut now. I'm gonna just start printing up the bases for these. And that is a rock. So we shall go with, what color are rocks? A mix of airbrushing and regular brushing. But what I'm trying to do is just base coat a lot of this stuff and then go back in there. And when I get in front of photos and stuff, I will detail it. So, you know, you get a lot of good little details and stuff on the rocks that, you know, base coat it and the tree and some other stuff and just kind of go from there. I'll primer these things real quick though. Primer is what helps the paint stick to whatever it is. This being resin, it's it's going to be a little difficult to paint without it sticking to it. I don't want to saturate it. I just want to do it sparsely. Sorry for the shadows, but I got a little bit of an overcast for this new camera getup I've got. What I'll do is I'll go in here and dab off some of the primer, because if you spray it too heavily and it gets coated into the little nooks and crannies, it can take away detail. So I just dab it. I'm not doing much more than just dabbing some of this wetness off. Excess. It's still primer coated, it's just not soaked. I'm using Krylon Gray on this. This is the primer that I'm using. It's 2-in-1. It's filler and sandable. It's Krylon Automotive Gray. I see this is the commando figure which stands on this base. So he stands there like this when he's done. Got a stud on the top there. Gotta be careful. I don't want to overspray and shoot spray on the other things I've done. Alright. Got that in the vase, and then I need to get the tree for Rambo. The tree is right here. I got all the parts, the main parts firmer that I've already started with these last night. Tried to go live, but didn't really want to let me. So, I'm done pretty quick. So I'm going to put these basic ones back in the box because I'm going to do some small detailing on those. Let's get this rock done first. I don't know what color I'm going to make this base. I think it'll be like a metallic color. But the rock will be a different, will be a bunch of different colors. I'm just laying a black gray on it right now. Put that aside and get the tree. rainbow tree, which is supposed to be a good one to do. There's going to be a whole bunch of colors. That's going to be mostly granite and mud. This one's going to be granite, wood, and mud. With foliage. There's going to be a mix of all kinds of colors. You got green, you got blue, not blue, you got red, green, brown. Try for some brown of some sort, not dark, dark brown, but it's a mix of browns. There's got to be quite a few. No, I want straight brown on there, but I do want something that's gonna be a light different coat. The base itself in kind of a caramel color. come back in there with a little bit different color. Oh, and it mixed up a muddy color or something somewhere. A little ball green, just a little bit of ball green. Mossy turns on the tree. Bit on the base. I'm trying to keep away from doing this in like one base color. I want a mixed color, so I'm kind of dispersing different colors in here just to make an alternate of mix, and then I will go back in with a wash and some other brushes and fine detail spots. Probably put a little bit of green tint in here too. Light green tint. The thing is, base coating these is the quick and easy, efficient way to do stuff, but going back in with fine-tuned brushes, which I've got right here, and hand painting everything with these little tiny brushes is what really makes the thing a whole difference. You know, it's just, it's amazing how well that works. Flesh colored, because it's not quite mud, but light colored, you know, in here. Just a little bit. That's more of a wash color. Messed up on that one. That might work. I'm just trying this one there. See how this works. Not too bad just for a vase. Set these aside, check in the house and work on later. Oh, completely got the underside shoot. I got that part. I'll get that. On the base here. Okay, now we're gonna figure out what we want Rambo's outfit to be. You're standing just like this on this tree. Put that aside. Alcohol in here. Gotta get his hair. So I got Jaws Quantum model. This is actually the only other resin model that I've done. This is, you know. So I found out that you guys can get this on eBay as well. So there are people that make these on eBay. Just print them out and sell them. This is a 1/10 scale. I wanted, not 1/10, it's a 1/8 scale. I wanted a bigger than a regular little bitty bitty one. I wanted something that was more to the NECA figure size if possible. So, now, let that dry, take it inside, start doing detail work. Gotta get his pee-pee. Can't forget the pee-pee. then get the honor arms. This is going to be a camo one, so I got to study the camo part and do that on this as well. Arnold's face, get his hair. Okay. I would airbrush his hair, but I like to do dry brushing on that and get that just the way I want it. But that's going to be camo for the face. I thought about doing that to Rambo, but I might camouflage his clothes a little bit. And that would be the thing that I'd do there. But it's a good start. And I went through the entire musculature and did flesh color and then did washes of yellow and red and blue to kind of get the skin tone. Then just kind of went back over it with a little light dermatitis. Just dry brushed a little dermatitis on there. So it's just getting started. I still got to detail the headband, the hair, the eyes. I got to get another little brush and do that. But you see the muscular definition that comes out when you multicolor it? So, okay, that's the start. It's never one flat color. It's always a mix of colors. It makes these things pop out. I just bored, not doing anything. Got some orders that are in, but they got to set up in the latex. So, you know, I'm just waiting for that to do that thing, that do its thing. And I can't really do much in the meantime. So what you gonna do but work on other stuff? So appreciate you guys watching. I'll keep you updated. Thank you.